It's taken much of this week for the results to come in. Professor Michael Wagner from the UW-Madison joins us this morning. Good morning.
Good morning.
So just talk about, what were your thoughts on hearing the speech last night?
Well, I thought the speech hit a lot of the notes that most Americans were looking to hear related to moving forward, related to some, you know, cooling of partisan temperatures, and also related to the agenda. Both Joe Biden and Kamala Harris talked about policies to deal with systemic racism. They talked about policies to deal with climate change, but both, of course, began with the coronavirus pandemic. And so those seem to be the top things on their minds.
Now, Professor Wagner, do you feel like the president will concede peacefully when it is time?
I have no idea. The president has telegraphed for months that he wouldn't be likely to accept a result where he lost. He now has a result where he lost. He's currently seeking remedy in the courts in a few different states, although it's not clear that there's any good evidence to base his current inquiries on, but we'll find out what happens. I think that the pressure is likely to keep growing on the president. People around the country, although notably hardly any elected Republicans, and then also lots of world leaders have been congratulating Joe Biden. So I think if elected officials in the Republican Party, so far I'm aware of Senator Mitt Romney in Utah doing this, I think there will be more pressure on the president to peacefully concede. But what he does, I think, is anybody's guess.
Now, when we look forward into the Biden-Harris administration on their platforms, what are some of the things that you're looking forward to seeing from that administration?
Well, again, I think the coronavirus task force is probably job one. It's what they spent a lot of their campaign talking about. Work dealing with climate change. I think plans related to systemic racism and police reform are likely on their docket as well. And then policies related to middle class workers and their kind of economic vitality seem to all be things that Biden has talked quite a bit about. And then there's healthcare as well. We'll see some of these changes come as quickly as they can through executive orders, but most of them will have to go through the Senate, which makes the two runoff races coming in Georgia incredibly important, because they will determine which party controls the majority in that chamber.
And lastly, Professor Wagner, when we look at the overall votes here in Wisconsin, were you surprised with just how that turned out?
It was a little bit closer than the polling suggested it would be. So far, there doesn't seem to be evidence that it was a shy Trump voter effect. It wasn't the case that people weren't willing to say who they preferred. It seems to be more a case of pollsters having a hard time finding a small but systematically important group of people who supported the president and getting them to agree to do the survey in the first place. But that's definitely something that we'll see pollsters and others try to do a lot of learning about in the coming days and months.
Well, thank you so much for joining us. We, of course, certainly appreciate this. Thank you.
It's my pleasure.